In this video, we're going to show you how to use the Hydrawise app to configure your controller. Click on the Let's Get Started link in your welcome email. This will take you to the Hydrawise app. If you are doing this on a computer, we'll use your web browser to connect you. Note that during this process, you will be asked to set up a password for your Hydrawise app. Welcome to Hydrawise. Let's run through the setup wizard by clicking the green button. In the wizard, you'll select a controller model, a name for the controller, a location, master valve information, add zones, and set watering times. After you select the model you are configuring, you will be asked to enter a name for the controller. If you are managing more than one controller, use a descriptive name like the customer's name and suburb or location of the controller. If you don't have a controller yet, you can skip the serial number entry on this first screen. Enter the exact address where the controller is located. This is important for two reasons. It will show you the weather stations nearest your controller that will help in adjusting your schedule, and it will also be helpful when viewing the location map to give you or your employees more accurate information on where the customer's controller is located. Your Hydrawise system uses weather stations to check and confirm weather events. We prefer to use fully maintained and regularly tested airport weather stations. Airport weather stations are the highest quality weather stations and ensure the best results for your landscape. However, if the airport weather stations are not suitable, then by upgrading to an enthusiast plan, we can give you access to up to 5 home weather stations. Home or personal weather stations are lower quality and maintained infrequently, so we receive typically lower quality information. However, we have worked out a way to best utilize this information. We recommend you connect to 5, and then we will check and compare them every hour and provide your system with the average of the 5 to give you the best result we can. The next step is configuring the master valve if your system has one. Then you'll add the information about the zones on your system. First, enter the name for your zone. Something that helps you remember its location is always a good choice. Next, select the zone number. Then, choose an icon for your zone. Hydrawise offers 2 types of watering, time-based and smart watering. Both offer similar water savings, but most customers prefer time-based watering as it is similar in operation to most traditional irrigation controllers. The next item to enter is the watering length. This is how long you want the zone or station to run. Then enter the watering frequency. Let's leave this at the default, every valid program start time. We have lots of options here, and you can go to hydrawise.com/support to find out about these other options. Finally, there's schedule adjustment. We can decide how the zone will react to changes in weather. The standard is to select Don't Water Extra when hot. For the use of other functions, go to our support site or click the Help button located in the lower right corner of your computer screen. Cycle and soak ensures that the water goes on your landscape and not down the street. This is great for slopes and heavy soils. Just enter the cycle time as the maximum time you can run your system before water starts to pool or run off. Then enter a wait or soak time, normally about 30 minutes. There is also a tuning feature that you can use to adjust the watering length for the zone. Once you have all the zones configured, you'll be asked to set the program start times. First, enter when you want the program to start. For watering type, use normal watering type. The other types are for unusual water restrictions. Next, select the days to water. By default, we have highlighted every day. Alternatively, you can select odd or even watering if you have this type of water restriction. Then you'll apply this start time to the zones you select. That's all it takes. When you click on the green button, you see the dashboard for the controller you just set up. Here you'll have an overview of the controller and be able to access all the additional features, including zone and schedule information, watering triggers, sensor configuration, and reports. If you entered a controller serial number while using the wizard, your controller is linked. If not, you must link your controller to your account before it will start watering by following these steps. From the dashboard in the app or your web browser, click on the settings icon on the blue watering schedule bar, and then click the Link to Controller menu item. Enter the serial number of your controller. The serial number can be found on the rear of the HC unit or on the inside panel of the Pro HC. You can also find it on the controller status screen. Once entered, you'll see the controller status change and you're all set. You also have the ability to use an uploaded image as a zone icon. To select an image to display on the dashboard, edit the relevant zone in Zones and Schedules by clicking on the icon in the lower right. Select your image, and then select Edit Zone. You will then be able to select the icon with the image you just set. Select OK, select Close, and you will see the image in your zone icon. You can also upload zone images directly from the Zones and Schedules page to display on the zone cards. Use the image upload icon to add images. To have the image display as an icon, you will need to edit the zone and select the zone icon that has your image attached to it. There is a lot more information in the support section of the Hydrawise website, so be sure to visit there and explore. Thank you for your interest in Hydrawise, and please contact us if you have further questions.